Hello everybody, this is part one of making 2D platformer series and I am going to teach you how you can do this. So let's get started. I have opened the Unity and let's click this new project. I'm going to name this project, let's say 2D. Platformer. And let's set templates to 2D and let's create project. Now our brand new Unity project is open. Let's manage the layout first and then we'll start making the game. Let's drag this game view on the left side and hierarchy on the right side. We don't need asset store. Let's set its resolution to 1920 by 1080. If you don't see these options, you can click plus and add from here. Now let's save this view. I'm going to save this view 2D. Platformer. Let's create our first folder by saying it's called scripts. Let's create a folder called prefab. Let's copy all the assets we required for this project. I have compiled the list of assets in this folder. Let's drag it into the Unity. Now we have four folders in our project: graphics, prefab, scenes, and skills. I'm going to rename this folder by underscore scene so that it appears as first folder. Let's get started. First, drag the main background of the level. So go into graphics folder. You'll see a pretty world background. Drag it to the hierarchy. Let's set its scales to double its scales, 2, 2, and 2. Move it a bit up so that all trees should appear. Let's call this sprite VG. We're gonna set its layer to -1 so that it appear always behind every object. Let's go into the folder called furry monster and drag any of the sprite into the hierarchy. Let's call this guy player. Let's set this layer to 0. We attach box collider. Let's edit collider. Let's double click on it. I'm going to disable background so that collider's boundaries should appear and more visible. So let's drag it a bit closer to the player and adjust it according to the shape of the player. Let's make it bit up from the feet of the player. For now, it's good to go. Let's add a background. We need something that player can stand on. So if you go into dirt glass folder and I'm randomly dragging this four sprites, let's make it bit smaller and add box collider 2D to it. And let's scale it more. Now if you play the game, the player should fall due to gravity. Let's make it a bit up. So I'm going to call this platform ground and test it again. Okay, now our first goal is to set all the animations of the player. So for that you can go to Windows, animation, and animation. I'm going to drag this tab here next to project and create a folder in the assets called animations. Okay, now open the animation tab here and drag the project tab very right to game tab and let's make this slider at its minimum position and click the furry monster. Now we want to create four animations: idle, walk, jump, and death. So for that you need to click on the player and click on this create button and navigate to an animation folder, and I'm going to call this folder idle. Now you can see that the frames for the idles are started from here and ending here. So I'm going to select all these frames and drag it to the animation view. And if I closely see player in the same mode, and if I play the animation from this centered button, and you can see that the player is animating, but it is animating too fastly. So we are going to reduce its speed, and I'm going to set the speed 24. So our idle animation is completed. Let's create the jump animation in the same way. Click on this idle button and create new clip. Jump. Let's call this jump. Let's drag it again. Now you can see that our character is jumping. Let's reduce its speed to 24 frames per second. And our next animation is walk. So create walk with capital W. Drag these all frames of walk here and reduce its speed by 24. And let's play this. As you can see that our character is walking. Now create the death animation. So I'm going to call this death. And we have only one frame for the death, so I'm going to drag it here. And it simply changed the sprite of player. So I'm going to drag this project window down here. And we don't need this animation tab anymore, so I'm going to close this tab. Now we want to set its animator so that we can make transition between these animation on the basis of our input. For that, we need to go to Windows, Animation, and Animator. And if you click on the player, and I'm going to make it a bit larger. Let's zoom in and drag. You can drag this view by pressing Alt button of the keyboard and left click. Now you can see that we have our four animation states here, and the yellow animation means that this is our default animation. Whenever the game starts, the idle animation plays by default. I'm going to arrange these animations like this. Let's drag this here, and I'm going to make transition between these four states. So for that, we need some parameters. Let's create two parameters. The first one of type float, I'm going to call it speed. The second one would be integer type, and that would be grounded. That would be true if the player is on the ground, and it will be false if the player is in the air. So let's make the transition between these states. So I'm going to click idle, make transition, and from back to jump, and then idle to walk, and walk to idle, and then walk to jump, and jump to. Now our diagram transitions are ready. Let's make these transition conditions. So I'm going to start with idle to walk. Let's set this has exit time to 0, uncheck, and 0. We don't need this. And let's set speed to greater than 0.1. So what does this mean is whenever the speed of the player is greater than 0.1, it should start walking. And grounded should be true because player can only walk on the ground. So from and the vice versa, and that would be reverse of it. No exit time, 0. We'll set it to speed less than 0.1. And grounded is equals to true. So grounded, true. So now we want it to do it for the jump. Let's click on the jump transition. Uncheck, 0. And speed should be less than 0.1. And grounded should be false because whenever the player jump, it will be in the air, so grounded will be false. Let's set it for this one. Speed less than 0.1. And grounded is equals to true. Let's set it from here. Walk to jump. Speed greater than 0.1 and grounded is equal to false. And jump to walk, speed greater than 0.1 and grounded True. And for the death animation, death can occur from any state. So I'm going to click make transition and set it to death from here. And we are going to create another parameter of trigger, and let's call this death. Click on the transition between any state and death. Set the condition to death. So our animator is set. In the next part, we are going to make our player run. See you guys next.